كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. ثم أما بعد، My dear brothers and sisters of Islam, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and check your deeds. Account yourself before it is accounted against us. Ya ayyuhan الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. اللهم اجعلنا من الفائزين المستبشرين. اللهم امين. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the month of Sha'ban started. And it is only few days to start the great competition to Al-Jannah. But as you know, Al-Jannah Tayyiba. Al-Jannah is a blessing. Al-Jannah is clean. Al-Jannah is an honor. And it is only for the clean people. For the honored people, for the blessed people, we are completing what we did start about mukaffirat al-dhunub, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for us to be forgiven. You cannot imagine how much blessing, how much mercy, how many chances Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes for us. In our two khutbah, we mentioned about the man who disobeyed for 40 years. He never ever approached Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a single deed. But once he decided to change Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deleted all his bad credit. Today, we are dealing with another example that deals with each one of us. We all commit sins. We all are not perfect. We all looking for the forgiveness and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rawi Imam Muslim عن أبي مسعود رضي الله عنه وأرضاه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبو مسعود رضي الله عنه وأرضاه narrated about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about a man from Bani Israel. Again, and I need every one of us to put yourself in his shoes, because we all having these problems. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always gave us the examples to encourage us. وتعالى to ask for his forgiveness, to catch every single chance, every single breath comes out from our bodies, for every single salah, for every single call to salah, Allahu Akbar, hayya ala salah, it is not the weapon, it is Allah.
Is to get more jobs,
more time to forgive the people
who couldn't pay their dues.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala been very happy.
And you know, no one is more generous than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, نَحْنُ أَوْلَى بِذَٰلِكَ مِنْهُ. This is more for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive, to delete, to clear the credits between people
than this man.
تَجَاوَزُ عَنْهُ forgive his sins, forgive his sins, forgive his sins, and he asked his angels to send him to Jannah.
Allahu Akbar. Allahumma ja'alna min al-'afin 'an nas ya rabbal alamin.
Few words. We all need to understand the husband with his wife. They have to forgive each other. She has to be patient. She has to forgive her husband's faults, mistakes, ignorance.
And he has to do the same.
It doesn't make sense if we raise our hand day and night.
Ya Rabb, اغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اغفر لنا عيوبنا.
تجاوز عنا التينا. We all have sins. We all have bad deeds.
But we don't forgive each other.
And we keep on calling and calling at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam attracting our attention about this great blessing. Ar-Rahimun, Yarhamur Rahman.
The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for anyone. Not for the people who had hearts. Not only for the people who has rude manners. Not for the husband who oppressed his wife. All the wife
who oppressed her husband.
The forgiveness, the mercy, the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not for the neighbor who oppressed his neighbor, who assaulted his friends.
Say sorry.
This example and the hadith is sahih.
In the volumes of Imam Muslim alayhi rahmatullah,
I have thought so much time
about this hadith.
لم يجدوا عنده من الخير شيء.
He was zero. Can you imagine?
Zero.
And we all, alhamdulillah, we all go to the mosque. We all come for Jum'ah.
We all do our fasting and everything,
but not all of us understood how to forget.
This is the manners of the people of Iman. Not everyone can forget. Not everyone can ignore. Not everyone can accept the apologize for his brother or his sister. We all might need to be like that man.
Allah only knows. The hadith didn't mention how old
when he died, 60, 70, whatever.
He knows the previous nations have so long life and had nothing.
But
كَانَ يَعْفُ عَنْ نَسِ اللَّهُمَّ عَفُ عَنْ بَيْرَ. I'm asking all of us now, if the husband and his wife forgive each other, you think we would have all this argument in our home?
We would have this high percentage of divorce. We would have all this amount of argument, of hatred, of rudeness between Muslims. It has no place in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called himself
Al-Ghafoor Al-Rahim.
Al-Ghafoor Al-Rahim. Here, you can
By chance, he came to join us now. And Allah wants to forgive, he will take him with a group as a blessing. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unlimited. 2 or 3 weeks away from Ramadan, I'm asking myself and all my brothers to have a couple of shirk. All our families have argued. All our relation is not proper. We need to prepare ourselves for Ramadan. Don't think you will start in Ramadan. Shaitan is playing games on you. You have to start from now. Promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to call your uncle that you didn't call him for ages now. To ask about your brother that you didn't see him for months now. To visit your parents. To forgive your brother. Whatever happened. This is a test. Allah knows we are human. We all memorize the hadith that a man complained to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, innani qaraba, I have a family. Asiluhum, I do visit them, but they never come. Wa ahnu alayhim, I am always kind to them. وَيَجْهَلُونَ عَلَيْهِ They are always rude and rough against me. وَأَعْطِيهِمْ وَيُمْنَعُونَ Ya Rasulullah, I always give them presents, gifts, charity, food, clothes, everything. But he never asked, Ya Rasulullah, do I need to carry on? He said, yes! This is a test. We are not going to do with Allah up to our situation. No. Up to the situation as it is. Whatever Allah asks, we have to say yes. And have forgiveness, tolerance, gentleness. Expecting the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this blessed month, Rajab has gone. Shaban start. In very few time we will say we are in Ramadan and it will go. And the death comes suddenly. We are not sure. I'm going to witness Ramadan. Are we going to complete fasting? Are we going to do all this long list? But we are sure. Once you promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rab, I forgive my brother, I forgive my wife, I forgive my neighbor, I forgive this man, I forgive this friend. Allah is more generous. He will never ever let you down. He will never ever lose your good deeds. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have to carry on. وَلَا يَزَلُ مَعَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ ظَهِيرٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا دُمْتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ And Allah himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is going to help, to support, to sustain you as long as you are good to your people, your family, your community. This was my message for this one. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from our hearts. To remove all the barriers from our families. To sort out all the problems between our brothers and our sisters. With the neighbors, with the countries, between the ummah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remind our ummah under la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters. Catch his chance to complete this sincere tawbah, this complete forgiveness, this complete promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are going to forgive ourselves and start a new stage before Ramadan. Let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Allahumma ameen. Allahumma antum mu'minun bi jannah. Peace. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا قيل لكم تفسحوا في المجالس تفسحوا يفسح الله لكم وإذا قيل لكم تفسحوا يرفع الله الذين آمنوا بكم والذين أوتوا العلم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلق الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله له لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري وأحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم آمين. My dear beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, don't think الشيطان will leave it to go easy. I'm sure is whispering to us now. Look, what your auntie said. Your uncle stole your inheritance. Your aunt, your mother-in-law, talked a lot about you. Your father-in-law said this. This is my mind. We don't live in a Jannah where the people of the Jannah are selected. We are in this area. Rasul himself was not safe. All the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the same situation. They accused them with everything bad, as you know. But we have a target. Our target is in Jannah. And every single way for in Jannah. Every single word for in Jannah. Every single chance for in Jannah. And if we don't do it now, it doesn't have any sense. If the death comes, you can't forgive now. You can't forget now. You can ignore now. But once our time is finished, it won't be accepted. I'm asking all my brothers and all my sisters, to make a double check about the argument, the problems we have in our families, with our friends, and compare it to what we'll say now. A very famous story. Allah mentioned this story in the Quran about one of the best women ever in history, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. After the prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is about the most beloved woman to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is about the woman Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Inni ruzaqtu hubbuha." His love was in my heart by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what I am going to talk about. Our great mother Aisha, As-Siddiqa, At-Tahira, Al-Afifa, radiallahu anhu wa rabbah. And where it comes from? From her cousin. From her cousin, Mustah, radiallahu anhu wa rabbah. As a human, he is not perfect. He fell in the gap that al-munafiqoon alayhim na'natullah did. And he talked about Aisha, who's at the time. And you know who's Mustah? Mustah is the adopted son, adopted cousin of Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu arda. Adopted cousin. All his clothes was bought by Abu Bakr. All the food he used to eat was from the money of Abu Bakr. The house he was living in was from the money of Abu Bakr. At the end, he talked about our great mother, Aisha Siddiqa, radiallahu anha. come from Muslim countries. And he knows this very well. If it happens, nothing. If anyone speaks about your daughter, your mother, your wife, he only use death. He killed them. It is not from Islam, but I'm telling you the culture. No one accepts any single word on his honor, especially for the woman. Abu Bakr didn't fight. Abu Bakr didn't beat him. Abu Bakr didn't kill him. Abu Bakr said, I'm going to stop spending money. This is the manner of these great people. And this is the minimum reaction. The minimum reaction. But do you think Allah accepted this behavior? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the incident in the Quran, in a whole surah. Mainly speak about Aisha and her father, radiallahu anhum wa radahum ajma'in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the incident to teach you and me. Of the other side, he is human. I don't think any of us has like Abu Bakr and his great daughter. When Abu Bakr stopped his difficult speaking with Mustafa, Allah named him and called him, Ya Abu Bakr, you are not the person who go down to this level. I know it hurts. When you speak about your mom, your daughter, yourself, it hurts. But you don't work for me one-to-one. What do we work for? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we expect that you are from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ولا يأتل أولو الفضل منكم والسعة أن يؤتوا أولي القربى والمساكين والمهاجرين وليعفوا وليصفحوا وليعفوا وليصفحوا. Let them forget. Allah called Abu Bakr and every single man or woman like Abu Bakr, Ulul Fadl, the people of honor, the people of generosity, the people of blessing, you will be one of them. You will join the group of Abu Bakr and his daughter because you follow his footsteps. I'm asking all my brothers and all my sisters again, وَلَا يَأْتَلِ أُولُوا الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ. The people of honor, Allah is calling at you to call your auntie, to forgive your uncle, to visit your cousin, to ask about your neighbor, to visit your friend, and don't say he said this, he said that. Never ever go down to him, but take him off. And يَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. Why are a question comes? Allah says, أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Don't you ask Allah for forgiveness? Of course we ask. Don't you love Allah to forgive you? Of course we do. So forgive people. وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. Again, check the ayah when you go home. If you have any problem, and we all, I'm sure we all have problems with wife, with daughters, with cousins, with everyone. وَلَا يَأْتَلِهُنُ الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَالسَّعَةِ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا بِالْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Abu Bakr said, بَلَا, of course, يَا رَبُّ وَنِيدُ. Because you ask Allah for forgiveness. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا يا رب. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتجاوز عما بر منا. اللهم ارحم تقصيرنا. اغفر لنا هذلنا وجدنا وعمدنا يا رب العالمين. واسرافنا في امرنا يا ارحم الراحمين. اللهم اصلح فساد قلوبنا. اللهم اصلح فساد قلوبنا. اللهم اصلح فساد قلوبنا. اللهم الف بين قلوبنا. اللهم الف بين قلوب المسلمين. اللهم الف